Welcome to the White Rock Reporter. I'm Johan Prost. I'm your host from coast to coast. This is a very impromptu visit I'm doing with the Lord's Prayer Ministry in Morris Farm in Painesville, Liberia. Now, I'm not really there. However, we are going to meet with a person that I had the pleasure of exchanging a few words with and ask questions. What is going on in this beautiful remote village? And I'm directing myself to Mary Mira Robson, and here you can see there's a little picture of her out in the field visiting with some of the beautiful people that she and a group of, I shouldn't say scientists, but anyway, welcome very much to the show. Please tell us a little, Mary, you are the owner of the Dancing Furs Bed and Breakfast in White Rock, British Columbia.
Yes.
You went out with a group and you have a great story to tell, and I'm going to give you exactly 8 minutes to tell us that on. How about that? So please tell us some pictures and be just inform us, because this was a very worthwhile trip you made.
Mm-hmm. Well, Johan, thank you for the opportunity to tell my story. I don't know if I could tell it all in the 8 minutes, but I will try to tell you what experience I had. I was very fortunate this March to go and see firsthand what a group of Canadians, dedicated Canadians who believe in children and educating children, can do. A Lord's Prayer Ministry was established in Regina, Saskatchewan. A Liberian, his name is John Kapwan, he had a dream of going back and educating children, first of all, to become productive members of society, but also to teach them to live together. He and his wife Cecilia adopted 68 children who live on the compound. And with Canadians' help, a group of Canadians who are helping, they are educating another 300 children from the local villages. And what I committed to do with John and for the Lord's Prayer, was to educate another 100 children for the 2010-2011 term.
So sorry for interrupting, but so within the scope of the Lord's Prayer's mm-hmm. ministry, you have initiated a very private initiative that you do, which is raising anywhere between $15,000 to $25,000 for caring for additional 100 students. Is that correct?
Yes, that's it was a commitment I made to John when I saw. In the medical clinic that we had a free medical clinic, and in the 5.5 days we were there, we saw 1,825 people, and there was a lot of children that came to that clinic that were 18 or 15 or 12 that had not gone to school for one day. Then I found out that literacy rate in some of the villages was as low as 8% and as high as 25%. So I thought, if every dollar that is given to this ministry is used, every single dollar is used at the Lord's Prayer in such a wonderful way, could we not give another 100 children an opportunity to go to school?
Each child, I understand, will take as much of $150 per child to accommodate them with the schooling education that is offered on the compound. Of course, they come from the outside of the village and they assemble and they go through school. They basically are afforded the opportunity.
Absolutely, and John is not making any money on this, on the children. He just wants to educate as many children as possible. That's why it's only $150 a year to educate one child.
It's mind-boggling, because what is $150? It is a dinner for two, if I may use that expression.
Yeah.
Maybe that's not exactly the analogy I would use, but it is a small amount, and where does it take the ministry as a
whole. This is a Canadian operation based a ministry in Alberta, I understand?
Yes.
Give us some contact information,
okay.
And I would be happy to write that in addition to on this little...
Right. Website is www.thelordsprayerministries.com, you could also reach me at www.dancingfurs.com, and my phone number is 604-538-3835. And so I will be in contact with them on a continuous basis. So what I want to impress upon people is that this every single dollar that's given to the Lord's Prayer goes to John and the children. The board of directors are volunteers, all volunteers. They don't take a penny for administration, and even the uniforms that are used by the children at TLP are sewn in Regina. There's a wonderful woman who sews all of these uniforms for the children. And the Blairs, the Turners, Blair and Evelyn Turner, they're some of the board of directors. When they go to visit TLP, they pay for all of their expenses out of their own pocket.
So it's a very voluntary base. Now, of course, any donations are, this is a registered ministry and benevolent society,
yeah,
if I can use that term.
Mm-hmm.
I like to say for the listener and for the viewer to understand that this is a legitimate operation. It is totally Canadian.
Yeah.
Is that correct? Correct.
Yeah,
correct me if I'm wrong now.
It's a Canadian registered charity, so that every dollar that you donate, as individuals donate, you know, you get a income tax receipt, and
you get the receipt for the donation, and it can be used as a write-off.
Right.
That's the way it is in life.
And the reason I agreed to this interview because I thought maybe, you know, with a publication of this video, there may be people who can be touched by a child, like one of these children.
Show us some photos here.
Look at these. These were the children at a free clinic. Most of these children are not going to get a chance to go to school. And
but
wouldn't
all
that
these
be
children,
wonderful? Yeah.
All these children, for some reason, they are still hopefully untouched, and they are very, very vulnerable.
They are.
And to offer this service from the Canadian community here, I guess nationwide, it is free to anyone to connect with the parish ministry and they do their... contribute in the way they feel. Anything small, anything large is fine,
mm-hmm.
right?
Yeah.
I think there is a reason that you can hear that I'm smiling when I say this and when I interview you, because I think it's such a good and worthwhile cause that it is just a pleasure to be able to be instrumental in bringing that forward.
Mm-hmm.
Now, show a few others, and I'll try to be here with a camera to see how we can bring this forward in a very, very...
Yeah, this is another...
Here they are, and here...
Here we are.
You look different there.
The African hairdo with the braids.
You became rather Afro all of a sudden. And I think that's wonderful.
Yeah, and this is the school. It's not a great shot of the school, but this is where the children go to school, and John, he interviews each child and interviews the parents too to make sure that they're committed.
But there is one thing you can show, and I think we should end with that, that is the picture of yourself with the blue background of the part of the school with Papa John.
And he's a Canadian citizen who escaped death in Liberia during the war, and he made a pact with God. If his life is saved, he will come back and make a difference with the children. He will teach them, he would educate them, teach them to love each other and bring peace to that country. And I would I support his dream, and I ask, can you afford $150 to educate one child.
Donate and do simply go to, as you can see here on the screen, very simply, thelordsprayerministry.com. Is that correct?
Yes, thank you.
Well, thank you an awful lot for having me on board here. It was a pleasure. Thank you very much.